0.45 megapascal to a pressure of 2 megapascal. It is then expanded adiabatically to a pressure of 140 kPa. The air is then cooled at constant pressure and finally restored to its initial state by an adiabatic compression. Refined for the cycle, determined for the cycle, the network done and the thermal efficiency. Gram of air at temperature 230 is expanded isothermally from a pressure of 3.45 megapascal to a pressure of 2 megapascal. So expanded isothermally, so from 3.45 megapascal to 2 megapascal. So based on the PV diagram that I have drawn, so you can see from point 1 here to point 2, okay, the pressure dropped from 34.5 to 20 bar. So point 1 to point 2, and then it obeys the law of PV equals to C, because it was stated that this is an isothermal process. So then from point 2 to point 3, the question has given us that it expands isentropically, okay, from the 2 megapascal, that means 20 bar, to 140 kilopascal. So that is 1.4 bar, it's not 0.14, it's 1.4 bar. Okay, so it's 1.4 megapascal. Okay, so from 20 bar, the system undergoes an isentropic expansion process further down to 1.4 bar actually. Okay, so it follows the law of PV to the power of gamma equals to C. And then from point 2, from point 3 to 4, it undergoes a cooling process, a constant pressure cooling process. So that is at constant pressure of 1.4 bar. Then lastly, the question say, okay, it compresses isentropically or adiabatically back to its initial point. That is what is stated that restore to its initial state point. So back to its initial state point to point 1, that is 34.5 bar. So that is the PV diagram. And so from the PV diagram, we have our TS diagram. So 1 to 2 is an isothermal process. So on the TS diagram, so isothermal supposedly to be a horizontal line. Huh? So 1 to 2. Then from PV diagram, 2 to 3 is an isentropic process. So that is 2 to 3. Okay, so that is a vertical line downwards. Okay, expansion, so temperature drop. Then 3 to 4 is a constant pressure process. So on the TS diagram, it is shown on a constant pressure line on the TS diagram. Then at point 4 to 1, again, it goes isentropically back to point 1. So restore back to point 1. So based on the TS diagram, we will be able to note down that this is the heat supply because an increase in entropy from point 1 to 2. And this is the heat rejected part, where you have a decrease in entropy from 3 to 4, that is rejected. So your heat supply, so that is equal to the area under the process path of a TS diagram. So you have the height, that is T1 or T2, multiplied by the base, that is S2 minus S1. So you can see from here to here. So you have S2 here and you have S1 here. So S2 minus S1. Okay? So that is a change of entropy for an isothermal process. Now then here you have heat rejected, that is at the constant pressure process. So that is given as MCP. T4, usually I take maximum minus minimum temperature, but we know that this is heat rejected. So it is actually, we don't have to put a negative sign, or we don't have to take always the minimum minus maximum. So you always try to ignore the negative sign. So I always take the maximum, minus the minimum temperature. So Cp can be taken as 1.006 in the question. Gamma can be taken as 1.4. And mass can be taken as 1 kg. So from here, you will be able to calculate your heat supply and your heat rejected. Then after that, the question asks for net work done. So that is heat supply minus heat rejected. And the thermal efficiency can be defined as net work out over heat supply. That's all for this question. 平安。